we look at all of these stories of disruption that I just talked about, all of these stories of transformation with platforms, we see four narratives that are repeated across all of these industries repeatedly. We see these four things happening repeatedly, and if there are symptoms of this in any industry that you participate in, that could be very well be an opportunity for a platform to come in again. The first is that if an industry has an inefficient gatekeeper, platforms solve the problem. What inefficient gatekeepers do is they prevent information from the supply side reaching the demand side. The classic case of information inefficiency or asymmetry is the used car business. Consumers never know what kind of car to buy because they never know how good that used car is. But in many different ways, that gatekeeping problem exists in many other industries as well. As I mentioned, in the publishing industry, the supply side never gets access to the demand side because there's an editor sitting in between. So whenever you have an inefficient gatekeeper, what a platform does is it comes in, re-intermediates that industry, and creates a more scalable and efficient gatekeeper. And so the market moves towards the platform because it's just more scalable and efficient. The second thing that platforms do is they unlock new sources of value, whether it's the Airbnb example that I mentioned in the beginning, or whether it's the mining example that I mentioned just now, that with the release of this data, you can start creating new startup mines that would never have been possible. So platforms always unlock new sources of value by democratizing the ability to produce. The third thing that platforms do is that they aggregate fragmented and inefficient markets. And a classic example of that is Yelp or TripAdvisor. The whole accommodation industry traditionally has been extremely fragmented, but TripAdvisor provides the decision support that consumers need to decide where they want to stay. And a final thing that platforms do very often is that they enable new production paradigms. If you think of what Wikipedia does, Wikipedia has taken a supply chain and has converted it into a network. Traditionally, if you had to create an encyclopedia, which is what Encyclopedia Britannica used to do, you would put people together into a room, they would decide what kinds of topics they want to write about, they would start writing that, they would have editors look at it, and then they would create this whole volume of books and push it out. And Wikipedia transforms this whole set of actions, unbundles it from a linear model, rebundles it into a network, and creates a living encyclopedia that is constantly updated. And the reason we haven't seen Wikipedia models increasingly so far has been that while platforms help in aggregating and matchmaking very well, coordination technologies that are required for coordination of multiple actions have been very nascent so far. Wiki as a technology has been one of the few coordination technologies that existed. But increasingly now, with artificial intelligence gaining a lot of ground, we're going to see a lot more coordination technologies come in. And so entire manufacturing supply chains can potentially move to a Wikipedia model in the future.